Hello children, good afternoon. Today you are going to learn Standard 9 Social Science History Unit 1 Evolution of Humans and Society Prehistoric Period. So already we have learned a lot in this lesson. So we are going to finish this lesson in this session, okay? And we are going to see megalithic burial megalithic barrier types. So barrier types, what is it, a barrier? So after the person dead, we'll bury the person, bury the body, you know, and the body bury panuvom. So here they are having different types of barrier, that is megalithic. Megalithic burial types. Here, men here. So we'll see our what are the burial types. Men here. Cyst. Then horn. Then sarcophagus. Then dolmen, then coracle, topical, particle. Since people created burials with large stones for the dead people, in Neolithic only they have found another proper system burial or dead person also in Paleolithic, Mesolithic period. And what they do is after the person there they throw it up, they don't have the burial procedure. In Neolithic period only they have started the burial procedure. In this Iron Age, they have different types of burial and they have used large stones to bury the people. They have built within these burials the skeletons or a few bones of the dead persons were placed along with grave goods including iron objects, carnelian beads and bronze objects. So here when the person dead, so they will keep some bones, skeleton bones and including all the what they have used on the grave and the color goods, grave goods. Goods means some important things for the people. Our favorite things are there. So, namalukku edhaavadhu or favorite things irukku appadina, so ornaments, jewels, stones, some things we have used. Nama use panna things are some artifacts. Idella vandha enna pannuvaanga, they will keep inside the burial. And the grave kulla enna pannuvaanga, with the body they keep those things up. So like that, what are the things they keep? Means iron object, some iron object and carnelian beads and bronze object, carnelian beads and some bronze object. These are the things they keep in the grave. What is the meaning of carnelian? Carnelian means some stones. Carnelian means some stones. So these are the things they keep inside the grave and these are called as grave goods. Some of the burials do not have human bones and they have only the grave goods. They may be called as memorial burials. So some things when they are in the grave, they do not have bones. The bones are the human body and the way it is, but they keep the goods and the grave goods and they are called as memorial burials. So what we call them as memorial burials. Nineve. Is it clear? And now, what is meant by grave goods? Grave goods means these are the objects placed inside the burials along with the physical remains of the dead. People may have believed that these would be useful in the afterlife. So, what they have, why they are keeping these goods inside the burial means they have that faith, enna belief, enna nambikirundanga appdin paathina after the life, adhaadha avanga irundhadhukku pinnaadi இந்த ஆர்டிஃபாக்ட்ஸ் இந்த திங்ஸ் எல்லாம் வந்து அவங்களுக்கு யூஸ் ஆகும் அப்படின்றது தான் அவங்களோட நம்பிக்கை. ஃபார் தட் ஒன்லி தே ஆர் கெப்ட் இன்சைட் த ரூட்ஸ். அண்ட் இஃப் யூ சீ இன் த எஜிப்தியன் பிரமிட்ஸ் இங்கேயும் அங்கேயும் வந்து அதெல்லாம் ஃபாலோ பண்ணியிருக்காங்க. யூ வில் பி கோயிங் டு சீ எஜிப்தியன் பிரமிட்ஸ் பற்றி நீங்கள் ப்ரீஃபாக வந்து நெக்ஸ்ட் லெசனில் எக்ஸ்பிளனேஷன் பார்க்க போறீங்க. அண்ட் எஜிப்தியன் பிரமிட்ஸ் ஆல்சோ தே ஹவ் ஃபாலோட் தீஸ் கைண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் திங்ஸ் பரியலில் வந்து இந்த மாதிரி திங்ஸ் எல்லாம் அவங்க ஃபாலோ பண்ணியிருக்காங்கன்னு சொல்கிறாங்க. Similar burials were also built in the early historic period. So, in the Mali burials on the early historic period are built funny in Kama of the Sangam literature. The Sangam literature mentions the various burial practices of the people. This burial types on the various people on the various things are followed on the according to their religious culture and the burial system and differ on the area. So, from that அந்த
buried under the earth and they have four slabs on the sides and
top, it will be closed. And if you see, for dolmen and cistern, both are having entrance level, they have the hole. So that hole is called as core hole. Why they have kept the core, the hole is, it is that there is a view that the soul of the spirit will move up. One dolmen, linear dolmen, or is this the system to move up. Now, urns are pottery jars and were used for burying the dead. Urns means they have kept the pot, or big pot, one big pot. They will keep the body inside that pottery. So that is called as urns, pottery jars. They will bury inside the pottery. Okay, urns. Next. Sarcophagi are burial receptacles made of terracotta. Sarcophagus are the burial receptacles. So they are made of clay. Sarcophagus, they are made of clay and it looks beautiful. And the burial is beautiful. They have so many legs. And a bathtub. It looks like a bathtub and will keep the body inside that tub. And keep all the flowers to keep on the flowers all are decorate panna. And this is made of clay, sarcophagus. This is made of clay. They sometimes have multiple legs, I told you, so they are having multiple legs. Menhirs are pillar-like stones erected as the part of the burials or memorials. And this is pillar-like. So they use this system for burials. The menhirs for heroes. They use for the heroes in the Iron Age. Heroes means in village level, there are minister, mayors, local mayors, village level leaders, young level bury panna. The menhir burial system follow panna. The tradition of hero stones might have begun in the Iron Age or even before. Now, podakol, topical and pathical. If you see this podakol means, it's like an umbrella shape. It is like an umbrella shape and topical is a hat stone shape and pathical is a wood stone shape. Wood mari, okay? Podakol means it's an umbrella. For that only they have seen. Say podakol. Topical means it's like a hat. It's covered. And wood pathical means it's a wood stone. Okay, now, so this is the megalithic burial type, very important one, megalithic burial types. Okay, so menhir, cist, urn, sarcophagus, dolmen, podakol, topical and pathical, these three systems are found in the area. And the way of image, which is they have, in the Mari or name of the use one in Ganga. Menhir means it's a pillar like burial, pillar Mari, and leaders, heroes, cist and dolmen is a table-like structure and cist is a buried under the earth and it is having four slabs on each four sides. Cist and dolmen having both holes and entrance of the burying system. Why they are using this both holes means it is there is a view that the soul or spirit moves from one dolmen to other dolmen and one sister to other sister. And urn means it's a pottery jar. So a big pottery jar to the body of the body part. And sarcophagus is having so many legs and it looks like a bathtub and it is made of clay. Okay. And dolmen, I told you, podakol, topical and pathical. So these are the megalithic burial types.
The people in the Iron Age practiced agriculture. As we all know, they have
started this agriculture, permanent residence, cattle, the pastoralist, இதெல்லாம் வந்து எந்த பீரியட்ல ஸ்டார்ட் ஆச்சுன்னா இந்த பீரியட் ஆஃப் நியோலிதிக், நியோலிதிக் பீரியட்ல தான் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணாங்க. So agriculture, the people in the iron age, so that is neolithic period, started agriculture, domesticated cattle and sheep, வீட்டிலே வச்சு வளர்க்க ஆரம்பிச்சாங்க, domesticated cattle and sheep, and some of the groups were still hunting and gathering. So neolithic period, some people have developed and some people still they were hunting and gathering. Millets and rice were cultivated. So in this period agriculture where they have domesticated cattle and sheep. They have domesticated cattle and sheep and millets and rice are cultivated. Then irrigation management developed. Irrigation means what? Tanneer paichal. So irrigation developed in the period. Of course, if agriculture is na main thing is irrigation. In this period, since many of the megalithic sites are found nearby rivers and tanks. So, nearby rivers, tanks, kitna, megalithic sites, nariya vandu things are. What are the things they have used na? Adha kandupidichirukka. And then in the deltaic regions, irrigation as a technology had developed, evidence of rice seen in the megalithic sites like Adichanallur, Thoothukudi district and Purundal near Palani. So in this in the agriculture and pastoralism, people are in the iron age, and what they did is they domesticated cattle, sheep, and they cultivated millets and rice. Irrigation process started, and rivers, tanks, kitla avangala kadaiyangal kadachidu nariya. And what are the sites, enter the sites la namu vandu ivangala things alla paakala, we can able to found that they have cultivated rice, millets, idala kandupidichirukanga. Adoda evidence la enga kadachidun paathina Adichanallur and Thoothukudi district and Purundal near Palani. So in Palani and Thoothukudi district we can able to find these ivangala idala pannirukanga abindrathukana evidence kadachirukku. Now iron age society and polity. Iron age society and polity.
Next one.
society, they had several groups of people, tribes, several groups. So, the size of the burials and the variations found in the burial goods suggest the existence of numerous social groups and their diverse practices. So, in this period, if you see the burials, burials are varieties. So, I told you now, megalithic burial times. So, they have a split and the religious and the kandupudi kambil. So, different kind of people in the Kaha, different teriyavar. And they had practices so many things differently. So, so now we are having so many people, no? They are following different religions, different cultures, traditions, different. Not everyone are same. Yeah, so, everyone on the same culture follow. We are having so many different cultures. So, they start by it. So, on the burial types of which they have they got an evidence. So, in the very different types of people in the Kama Pinsu. Some of them seem to have had organized chiefdoms. So, or kingdom on the rule panikamari or Vishya. So, if the men here, they'll bury, the men here burial type, they are bury panama. So, the leaders, poor Talekar, Amari Peri Alular family, village. So, all the men here in the burial type use panika. So, other chain of panikama, evidence is a chiefdoms like in the Kama. Cattle lifting leading to wars and encroachment and expansion of territories had also started taking place in this period. In this period, cattle on the third day to go. So if you can you able to see this? Yes. So black and red ware. Now we'll see iron technology and metal tools. tools. The megalithic burials have appended iron objects placed in the burials as grave goods. So here in megalithic burial types, we saw no Sangapathina, they will place some iron objects inside the grave. Or a table, these things are found in the burial. So in the burial also, they have used iron technology. What other things they have found? Edella vanda the grave la vande vepangal paathina sword, these are the iron ala make panadhu sword, daggers means it's a short knife. Daggers means it's a short knife, axes, chisels, lamp, then tripod stand. So these are the things they have found in the iron, or the megalithic burial, in the grave, they keep these things which is made of iron, okay? Some of these objects were hafted to wooden or bone or have horn handles and used. So some of these objects vandu edhukna kai pidi adhavadhu indha objects sword irukkiya sword daggers idoda handles la enna pannirupanga pathina woods and bones, you know already. So woods bone horn handles, so idhula dhaan vandu idoda handles la vandu make pannirukanga. The iron tools were used for agriculture. each 1 unit is equal to 500 years. So if you see this, in this period 300 BC. So 100, 200, 300. 0, 100, 200, 300. In this period, you have to write early historic period. The next one is 500. In 500 days, 500 BC, Iron Age. This is the Iron Age period, 500 BC. And 1000 is a Neolithic period. Neolithic period. Hence, 1000. BC. Then 1300 BC, Mesolithic. Period. 1300 BC. Then in 2000, it is Neolithic period.
Now with this we have finished the first unit fully. So many things are there. So
So we have studied the Paleolithic, Mesolithic, Neolithic, Upper Paleolithic, Lower Paleolithic, Middle Paleolithic, and Mesolithic, Upper Mesolithic, Lower Mesolithic, and then Neolithic, how they have started. So this lesson is the evolution of humans and society, how they have developed stage by stage. Humanum sari, societyum sari, eppadi vandu ஒருங்கிணைந்து எப்படி டெவலப் ஆயிருக்காங்க அப்படின்றத நம்ம இந்த லெசன்ல பார்த்தோம். அண்ட் ப்ரீ ஹிஸ்டாரிக் பீரியட், ப்ரீ ஹிஸ்டாரிக் மீன்ஸ் வி டோ நாட் ஹேவ் எனி ரிட்டன் ரெக்கார்ட்ஸ், தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் ப்ரீ ஹிஸ்டாரிக் பீரியட். ஸோ ஸோ மெனி திங்ஸ் வி ஹவ் லேர்ன்ட் இன் திஸ் லெசன், வெரி இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங் லெசன்ஸ் லெசன் இட் இஸ். ஸோ வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் ஆல்சோ. ஓகே, நவ் வில் மூவ் டு த நெக்ஸ்ட் லெசன், யூனிட் 2, ஹியூமன் ஏன்ஷியன்ட் சிவிலைசேஷன். This is also a very interesting lesson. You people think that history might be bore, but you can able to know different things, what are the things they have started. So many things are clear. So every month or a theorem when they come to start pandranga, or what use pandranga, when they create pandranga, clock ya enga to kandupidichanga, so many things are there. So by studying these things we can able to know how they are created, enga irundala namakku create aachu pandranga. Now ancient civilization, what is mean by civilization? In Tamil we used to say nagarigam. So different cultures we are following, no? Ancient civilization na palangala nagarigamal, eppadi la vandha avanga endha nagarigam, eppadi culture vandhu use pannanga, eppadi la irundanga people, what dress they wore, what kind of dress, what kind of makeup, what kind of hairstyles, so many things were there, no? So adha pathi da nama paaka porom. And in ancient civilization we are going to learn endha culture, endha country oda culture paaka porom paathina ancient civilization. So in this lesson, ancient civilization, பழங்காலத்துல தொன்மையான வளமையான நாகரிகம், அத பத்தி தான் இந்த லெசன்ல பார்க்கறோம். In this lesson we are going to discuss what are the என்ன culture, என்ன கண்ட்ரியோட cultures எப்படிலாம் இருந்தாங்கன்றத பார்க்க போறோம்னா, Egypt civilization, Mesopotamian civilization, Chinese civilization and Indus Valley civilization. Is it clear? Now in this lesson we are going to learn about early societies and state formations. In this lesson you are going to learn about early societies. So early societies and state, every last state what are there to the state formation, every last nadandhu, then you are going to understand the development of civilization. So how they have developed, development of civilization. So first development avanga irukku appadina enna artham, first in Paleolithic period Australopithecines, what they have used, they don't wear dress, they don't have dress, what they just do, they need the food to live. What they did, they hunt the animal and the plants, the fruits and nuts illa saapidha vaazhndha. And state by state what they did, they cover up the body with the grasses, the leaves, plants, idha vechi cover panna start pannanga. Then what they did, they had started, so stage by stage hunting, gathering, what they did, they did farming, agriculture start pannanga. Then they need water, so river kitta irukra edama paathu they started agriculture, and they started to live in a permanent residence. Where they live first in the cave only. So ஆச்சு அப்படிங்கறத பாப்போம் and then to learn about the ancient egyptian civilization very important very interesting and very oldest civilization ancient Then the next one is to study the main features of Mesopotamian civilization. I already told you, so Egyptian civilization, Mesopotamian civilization, then Chinese civilization, then Indus civilization. Clear? Indus civilization. So these are the things we are going to learn in this lesson. Very important lesson, very interesting lesson. So early societies. ஆர்லி சொசைட்டி சமூகம் வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் எப்படி இருந்தது ஸ்டேட்ஸ் எப்படி பிறந்தது டெவலப்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் சிவிலைசேஷன் நாகரிகம் எப்படி டெவலப் ஆச்சு டே பை டே ஏன்ஷியன் எஜிப்தியன் சிவிலைசேஷன் மெசபோடாமியன் சிவிலைசேஷன் சைனீஸ் சிவிலைசேஷன் இந்தஸ் சிவிலைசேஷன் சோ திஸ் இஸ் தி ஹோல் திங் யூ ஆர் கோயிங் டு லர்ன் இன் திஸ் லெசன் நவ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வில் சீ தி இன்ட்ரோடக்ஷன் பார்ட் ஆஃப் திஸ் லெசன் ஓபன் சொசைட்டி இஸ் தட் அடாப்டட் ways of life were more organized than the early hunter-gatherer and Neolithic farming societies. So here first they have started with the hunting gathering and Neolithic. Neolithic means you know as usual. So permanent residents were there. They have domesticated cattle, sheep. So they did farming, agriculture. So irrigation process developed. And then different professionals were there. So in the modern things, along with the Neolithic period, they started. So they were organized. அதாவது அவங்களோட ways of life வந்து ரொம்ப complicated ஆ இருந்தது. So the complex life, different ways of life they had. Urban societies had social stratification and well-planned cities. Urban societies means what? இந்த மாதிரி town cities. So developed, well-developed cities இருக்கு. Yeah, so அவங்க என்ன பண்ணாங்கன்னா cities வந்து well planned ஆ இருக்கு அப்படினா என்ன அர்த்தம் well planned cities means what they have food they have dress to wear and they have food dress then what is there so they have well engaged different professionals were there in that period then they practiced crafts engaged in trade and exchange adapted science and technology and formed a political organization in this period what they did is they have developed a craft நிறைய craft அதாவது கைவினை பொருட்கள் நிறைய செய்ய ஆரம்பிச்சாங்க ஹேண்ட்லூம் இப்போ நம்ம யூஸ் பண்ணுறோம் இல்லையா ஸோ ஹேண்ட்லூம் கிளாத்ஸ் ஹேண்ட்லூமில் செய்யப்பட்ட திங்ஸ் ஸோ இதெல்லாம் வந்து அங்கே அவங்க டெவலப் பண்ணதுனால தான் நம்மளுக்கு இப்போ தெரியும் அண்ட் தென் தே ஹேவ் ட்ரேட் ஸோ ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ட்ரேட் எக்ஸ்சேஞ்ச் மீன்ஸ் வாட் ட்ரேட் எக்ஸ்சேஞ்ச்னா இன்கேஸ் இஃப் இன் மை கண்ட்ரி இஃப் ஐ ஆம் ஹேவிங் லாட் ஆஃப் ரைஸ் அண்ட் இன் தட் கண்ட்ரி ஸோ பட் ஐ நாட் ஹேவிங் சம் கிரெயின்ஸ் எங்கிட்ட கிரெயின்ஸ் இல்லை பட் இன் தட் கண்ட்ரி தே ஆர் ஹேவிங் லாட் ஆஃப் கிரெயின்ஸ் அங்கே நிறைய உற்பத்தி ஆகும் நிறைய விளைவு அப்படின்னா வாட் வில் டூ வில் எக்ஸ்சேஞ்ச் இல்லையா ஸோ எங்கிட்ட அரிசி இருக்கு எங்கிட்ட இருக்க அரிசியை நான் உனக்கு தரேன் உங்ககிட்ட இருக்க பருப்பை எனக்கு கொடு ஸோ தட் ட்ரேட் எக்ஸ்சேஞ்ச் தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் ட்ரேட் எக்ஸ்சேஞ்ச் அண்ட் அடாப்டட் சயின்ஸ் அண்ட் டெக்னாலஜி So lot of science improvement in science and technology and they formed some political organization arasiyal kootangal nareye vandu organize panna start pannaanga hence the term civilization is used to distinguish them from the early forms of societies for that only we are using this word civilization so early form of civilization ipa irukka civilization eppadi irukku nagarigam vandu appa eppadi irundhathu ipa eppadi irukkunnathu da nama differentiate distinguish பண்றதுக்கு இந்த வார்த்தை யூஸ் பண்றோம்னு சொல்றாங்க. However, they should not be considered superior to other forms of societies since each culture of civilization has its own unique features. For that, we should not compare. So Egypt civilization now there is a Indus civilization now there is a Indian civilization now big we are improving, we are better and compare பண்ணா each are unique in their way of implementing new things. ஒவ்வொருத்தரும் அவங்களோட new things வந்து இம்ப்ளிமெண்ட் பண்றது யூனிக்கா இருக்காங்க ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் இந்த கிளாஸ் இஃப் 10 ஸ்டூடண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் தேர் நாட் 10 ஸ்டூடண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் நாட் 10 ஸ்டூடண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் ஸ்டார்ட் தே வில் ஸ்டடி வெல் இல்லையா 10 பேருமே நல்லா படிக்கிறவங்க அப்ப 10 பேராலுமே ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ரேங்க் எடுக்க முடியாது ஈச் ஆர் ஹேவிங் டிஃபரண்ட் யூனிக் ஃபீச்சர்ஸ் ஈச் ஆர் ஹேவிங் டிஃபரண்ட் டேலண்ட்ஸ் ஒவ்வொருத்தருக்கும் என்ன இருக்கு டிஃபரண்ட் டேலண்ட்ஸ் இருக்கு So, and the marina, our culture, actually, we should not say that this is the highest country, this is the well-civilized country, so this is the introduction part of this lesson, ancient civilization. Now, we will move on to ancient civilization, the introduction part of civilization is seen as an advanced, organized way of life. It instilled a way of life that could be considered as an adaptation to particular environment and cultural context. When it became necessary for large number of people to live in close proximity, they brought in planning, organization, specialization. Okay, now in ancient civilization, they are having different things. That is, they planned, they brought in. அதாவது க்ளோஸ் ஃபர்ஸ்ட்லாம் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா இந்த பாலியோலிதிக் பீரியட் டிஃப் அதாவது அவங்கவுங்க ஒரு ஒரு ரீஜனில் வாழ்ந்துட்டு இருப்பாங்க. தே ஆர் நாட் இன் க்ளோஸ் ப்ராக்சிமம். வென் பீப்புள் கம் க்ளோஸ் இன் ஒன் சொசைட்டி, ஒரு வில்லேஜ் ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், இந்த வில்லேஜ் ஆல் த பீப்புள் ஆர் லிவிங் அப்படின்னா வாட் தே டூ, தென் ஹேவ் ஒரு ஸ்ட்ரீட்டுக்கு ஒரு லைட், தென் ஒரு ஸ்ட்ரீட்டில் ஒரு வாட்டர், ஒரு வாட்டர் டேங்க், ஸோ இந்த மாதிரி இருக்கும் இல்லையா. ஸோ வென் பீப்புள் ஆர் கேதர்ட் இன் அ க்ளோஸ் ப்ராக்சிமிட்டி, வாட் தே ஹேவ் டு டூ, தே ஹேவ் டு டெவலப் ஈச் அண்ட் everything. So they brought in planning, plan பண்ணாங்க, organization கொண்டு வந்தாங்க. So in ஒரு இப்ப நம்ம பாக்குறோம் இல்லையா, political organization எப்படி நடக்குது, ஏன்னா ஒரு ஒரு சிட்டிக்கு வந்து they having one leader, ஒரு தலைவர் இருக்காரு, and then counselor is there. So ஒரு ஒருத்தருக்கும் ஒரு group, ஒரு ஒரு work இருக்கு. So to keep that village neat and clean and to develop that village, ஒரு அந்த village நம்ம என்ன பண்றோம், develop பண்றோம். Like this, they had a planning, they had planning, organized and specialization. இதெல்லாம் improve பண்றாங்க. Settlements were planned and laid out, a polity emerged, society became organized and food production, craft production were generated. So society, group of people came together and lived in a society. So the society, ஒரு சமூகத்துல வாழ்ந்து வாழ்ந்தே அவங்களால என்ன பண்ண முடியும், டெவலப் தான் ஆகணும் இல்லையா. ஸோ they are developed in craft, food production, food வந்து நிறைய உற்பத்தி பண்ண ஆரம்பிச்சாங்க, craft நிறைய செய்ய ஆரம்பிச்சாங்க, and these are regulated. இதெல்லாம் நடந்துட்டே இருந்தது. Take shape, huge buildings were built, the heart of writing developed, and science and technology contributed to the betterment of society. So as society indha mari or side valandhe irukkum enna achna, they have developed a huge building. So very very building katta aarambichanga, then heart of writing. So first and all, they have used pictograph. What is meant by pictograph? Instead of writing, they show the images. Yeah, so அந்த மாதிரி பிக்டோகிராஃபை யூஸ் பண்ணாங்க. பட் தே ஹவ் ஸ்டார்டட் த வே ஆஃப் ரைட்டிங் இன் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் ப்ரொசீஜர்ஸ், தே ஹவ் டெவலப்ட் சயின்ஸ் அண்ட் டெக்னாலஜி. வாட் இதெல்லாம் எதுக்காக அப்படின்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, சொசைட்டி பெட்டர்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் சொசைட்டி. சொசைட்டி வந்து எப்படி ஆச்சு, நல்லா பெருசாக வளர ஆரம்பிச்சது. Now, the Egyptian, Mesopotamian, Chinese, Indus were the important early civilization. So they are the, why we are saying as Egypt, Mesopotamian, Indus, Chinese, இதெல்லாம் ஏன் இம்பார்ட்டன்ஸ் சொல்றோமா, நிறைய நிறைய புது விஷயங்கள் எல்லாமே கண்டுபிடிச்சது வந்து இந்த சிவிலைசேஷன். இந்த பீரியட்ல இந்த மக்கள் தான் வந்து நிறைய விஷயங்களை வந்து கண்டுபிடிச்சாங்க. For that only we are saying these are the important civilizations. While these civilizations flourished in certain regions, people in other parts of the world lived as hunter-gatherers and pastoralists. The hunters, gatherers and pastoralists maintained their relationship with these civilizations through interaction. Their history is also equally important. During the time of these civilizations, South India witnessed the emergence of Neolithic agro-pastoral communities and microlithic form of life by hunters and gatherers. While these are developing, so in the ancient civilization, they have developed food-wise, cloth-wise, heart-wise, craft-wise and way of writing. So, this is a huge building. This is a huge building. But in some part of region, still a part of region, the people were still hunter-gatherers. So, food kaga vandha hunt pannittu gather, food gather pannittu indha mari process la dhaan irundanga. But we should not say that idella important kadaiyadhu solrunga, they are also in the kind of people no romba important da appdi solranga. Is it clear? Now we'll enter into the Egyptian civilization. Yes. So very, very important one, Egyptian civilization. So this is one of the oldest civilization. The Egyptian civilization is known for its monumental architecture, agriculture, arts, science and crafts at a very early age. So here, this is one of the very oldest civilization. And what are the things they have? எதுக்காக இது பெருசா தெரிய வந்தது? எதனால வந்து அவ்வளோ பெரிய விஷயம் ஆச்சு அப்படின்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, they were known for its monumental architecture. Then agriculture, arts, science. Science and crafts. For these reasons, the Egyptian civilization become a very well-known civilization. Surrounded. The Egyptian civilization depends solely upon the flow of Nile River, and hence Egypt was called the gift of Nile by the Greek historian Herodotus. I already in the first class I told you who is known as Herodotus, father of history. Who is known as the father of history? Herodotus is called as the father of history, and he is the Greek historian, and he only said that Nile River is the gift of Nile. Gift of Nile. So I feel as of the Egypt was a is a gift of Nile. Okay. So Egypt civilization was a they were fully dependent on the Nile River. They were fully dependent on the Nile River. Is it clear? So Egypt civilization is one of the very oldest civilization. For what is this well known for is they are having monument architecture. They have developed the well in agriculture, arts, science, and crafts. And where it is, in African continent, in the east part, Egypt was there, and it is irrigated by the Nile River. Nile River, originate Lake Victoria in the south, and it flows to Mediterranean Sea in the north. And Egypt, which is surrounded by Red Sea in the east and Mediterranean Sea in the north. And we say that Nile River is surrounded in between, another desert area. Rendu side of desert area, in between Nile River is there. And Greek historian Herodotus in a Sudara gift, Egypt is called as the gift of Nile. The Nile also served as a means of transport. So Nile River for the transport ko use panirukanga. The Nile Valley is very rich and fertile. So this river, the valley for the transport ko use aayirukku. And it is very rich and fertile river. Yeah, we solra appadina it deposits fresh alluvium every year. It deposits fresh soil. Fresh alluvium means fresh soil every year. This alluvium nurtured agriculture and helped to produce surplus of food grains, leading to the development of Egyptian civilization. So in the river, fresh soil இத கொண்டு வரதால they have developed in agriculture, and they have lot of food. Surplus of food means they have lot of food. உணவுக்கே பஞ்சமே கிடையாது. இதுதான் இந்த நைல் ரிவர் வந்து leads to. This is one of the reason that they have not developed. The Egypt civilization develop பண்ணதுக்கு ஒரு reason. The dry regions on both sides of the Nile are were kind deserts. So in the dry region is real deserts. இது அவ்வளவு remains desert. அப்படியே அது பாட்டே பண்ணமாதான் இருக்கு. So this is about Egypt civilization, and more is there. So this is the introduction part of Egypt civilization, one of the oldest civilization. They are having lot of monument architecture. They have developed a very well versatile in agriculture, art, science, and crafts. And where Egypt located is in the African continent north east part. The Egypt is located, and it is surrounded by Red Sea in the east and Mediterranean Sea in the north. Now we'll see So who were called as Hyksos? Hyksos were the rulers of 15th dynasty. Hyksos were the rulers of 15th dynasty of Egypt, and they were probably from West Asia. They were not the Egyptians. They came from West Asia. Descent who invaded Egypt and settled in the Nile Delta. They formed the 15th and 16th dynasties of Egypt and ruled a large part of the country. They were the rulers. So they were the mixed people of Semitic and descent. So in the region of the rule panitanga, 15th, 16th dynasty, both the party of Enapanitanga, the Hyksos people on the rule panitanga. Now we'll see about the Greek people, Persians. So Persians are the people from the region of Persia. So Persia Egypt Pandama, and they are the ancient Iran. And then Greek people, Greek refers to the language and people of modern day state of Greece and Europe. And then next, Rome refers to the ancient Roman Empire. And which acts is the capital city, Rome in Italy. So these are the Hyksos, Persians, Greek, Rome, in the region that the people are in the they came to Egypt and somewhere ruled the country. The Egypt and more important on the Hyksos. So they were there for 15th and 16th dynasty. And they came from West Asia. People, that is mingle like on the ground, not one kind of people. One region of people were there. So many regions and the people were there. And Persians are the Persian people, and they came from Iran. And Greek people, so it's a language and Greece in Europe. And the country is called the Roman people, Roman Empire, they ruled there. And Rome in Italy, the modern state of Rome, so and the country number one the rule part. Now children, we'll see the continuation part in the next class. Thank you.